The Trumps just shocked everyone when the cameras caught what they never did at the Pearl Harbor Memorial. There is a huge difference between President Trump and Obama, like the difference between night and day when it comes to supporting our veterans. I, as an American veteran, can easily spot the difference. President Trump truly cares about the military and veterans, and he himself visited World War II veterans at Pearl Harbor to attend a memorial ceremony for the fallen who died 80 years ago from the surprise attack from the Japanese. If you don't believe me, just look at the pictures in this article. You can see the sincerity and love he has for veterans. President Trump takes the time to hear the concerns from veterans, no matter the age or the war they fought in. All veterans matter to President Trump. The love is obvious from President Trump, unlike from Obama and his administration. When Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe visited Pearl Harbor, Obama's White House Press Secretary Josh Earnest told the World War II veterans to get over it when it comes to the feelings of veterans who may be offended over Japanese Prime Minister's visit. President Donald Trump and First Lady Melania Trump laid a wreath and threw hibiscus flowers into the sea on Friday at a Hawaii memorial for U.S. soldiers who died at Pearl Harbor nearly 80 years ago. Embarking on his first official tour of Asia, Trump said he eagerly anticipated a visit to Pearl Harbor, where thousands of service members paid the ultimate sacrifice. Getting ready to land in Hawaii. Looking so much forward to meeting with our great military veterans at Pearl Harbor. Trump tweeted aboard Air Force One as he neared the end of a 10-hour flight from Andrews Air Force Base in Maryland. Trump toured the USS Arizona Memorial at Pearl Harbor, which marks the resting place of more than 1,000 sailors and Marines who were killed on the battleship during the Japanese surprise attack on December 7, 1941. Accessible only by boat, the memorial straddles the battleship's sunken hull. More than 2,300 sailors, soldiers and Marines died as a result of the attack, as well as 68 civilians, according to the National Park Service. Trump saluted after entering the memorial following a short boat ride with the First Lady. They approached a wreath of white flowers, a gift from the couple, and watched as two sailors placed it near a wall of names of those who died after a surprise attack by Japan that plunged the U.S. into World War II. The Trumps then tossed white flower petals into the water above the battleship's sunken hull. Trump did not speak publicly at the memorial. He said during an earlier meeting with military officials that he eagerly anticipated the visit. Trump landed in Hawaii on Friday as he set out on the longest trip to Asia by an American president in more than a quarter century, looking for help to pressure North Korea to stand down from a nuclear crisis. Trump and his wife arrived at Joint Base Pearl Harbor Hickam late Thursday after a day-long flight from Washington. He departs Friday for Japan, the first stop on the five-nation, 11-day Asia journey. The First Lady left Washington in a winter jacket and electrifying cobalt blue, but changed mid-flight into a sleek white sundress that bared her arms. Upon landing, the Trumps were both handed traditional leis, the wreath of flowers worn around the necks that are presented upon arriving or leaving Hawaii as a symbol of affection. Just after 1 p.m. local time, Trump and the First Lady were greeted on the Hickam Air Force Base tarmac by Hawaii Governor David Ige and his wife Donna Manoa Ige. Via the Federalist Papers. The Obama administration has done and said many things that have surely set millions of Americans' blood boiling, and this is high on the list as one of the worst. White House Press Secretary Josh Earnest called World War II veterans embittered if they object to Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe's planned visit to Pearl Harbor. With, at this point, no comment about remorse for the attack. White House Press Secretary Josh Earnest said during a press conference Monday it was national for World War II veterans to be embittered about Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe's visit to Pearl Harbor, but they should get over it for the sake of America. It was announced Monday that Abe will be the first Japanese leader to visit Pearl Harbor since it was hit by a surprise attack that killed 2,403 Americans and brought the U.S. into World War II. The visit reciprocates President Barack Obama's visit to Hiroshima earlier this year for the anniversary of the atomic bomb attack on the city. Abe said in a short statement he would pray for those who died in the war, but gave no indication he would express regret for Japan's surprise attack. During a White House press briefing Monday, Ernest was asked whether veterans may be offended by Abe's visit if he expressed no regret over the attack. Ernest was asked about whether or not veterans will be offended if Abe visits Pearl Harbor, but does not express regret for the attack. Ernest responded, "If I were a World War II veteran who was drafted by the United States military to go and fight for our country overseas in the aftermath of the Pearl Harbor attack, I might feel quite embittered, and I think it would be a perfectly natural and understandable human reaction to not be particularly satisfied with the words of the Japanese Prime Minister." So Ernest is well aware of the natural and understandable human reaction to the visit by Abe should he not express regret over the attack, yet take a look at what he said next. "Yes, there may be some who feel personally embittered," he said. "But I'm confident that many will set aside their own personal bitterness, not because they're personally satisfied by the words of the Prime Minister, but because they recognize how important this moment is for the United States. You know, I've heard a great deal of offensive things from this administration, but even after 8 years of this garbage, this still took my breath away." When you are in the military, you are part of a family, and when you lose soldiers in the battlefield, it's like you lost a family member and you will never get over it. Like what Ernest and Obama expect from the World War II veterans to do. "I have lost 7 soldiers in the deployments. I will never forget them. Being in a surprise attack from the Japanese, that caused the death of a lot of military members, I can assure you that they will never get over it, and they have the right to feel how they feel about it." It is well known that Democrats do not care about the military and veterans by their voting record when it comes to voting on military benefits and programs. It is not surprising that veterans' lives do not matter to Democrats. I am thankful that we now have a president that does care about military and veterans, and life for them will start looking a lot better over time. The Trumps never threw America under the bus. They never apologized, and they didn't bring the Japanese Prime Minister over to disrespect the fallen, like the Obamas did.